Fordham returns home tonight after two tough losses against Big Ten opponents on the road. They're looking to even their early season record when they host D1 newcomer UMass Lowell next. Welcome to the Atlantic 10 Network on SNY. From Rose Hill Gym in the Bronx, the Fordham Rams look to get back to 500 against UMass Lowell. The Riverhawks closing a five-game road trip to open the season. And welcome, everyone. I'm Ed Cohen. Great to be joined by the former college coach, Vin Parisi. Fordham ventured into Big Ten country and came away with losses at Penn State and at Maryland, but they're back home where last week, freshman Eric Pascal put on a show.
He's one of the most highly touted freshmen that Fordham University has had in a long, long time. November's not even over with yet, and he's already earned Atlantic 10 Player of the Week honors.
Now, Pascal did not play at Maryland. He was here in New York undergoing medical tests, but the good news for the Rams, he's all cleared for this one.
At 6'6", strong, big for his size at age 18, he will be a matchup nightmare for guys when conference play comes.
This is Tom Pecora's fifth year leading Fordham. He believes he has put together a roster that's ready to take the next step.
And it's about players. You know, we coach them up a little bit, put them in positions to be successful, but you've got to have talent on the floor. And we have more talent on the floor now than we have since I've been at Fordham.
The Atlantic 10 on Atlantic 10 on SNY is being brought to you by Aer Lingus. Fly Irish to Ireland and Europe. For the best fares, visit AerLingus.com. By the Fordham Maroon Club and by Coca-Cola, proud sponsor of Fordham basketball. Fordham Rams being introduced to this crowd at Rose Hill Gym. Welcoming UMass Lowell, the squad out of the America East in their second year in a four-year transition into Division I. They'll be a full-fledged member in 2017-2018. Some major news with Fordham. For more, we go to the third member of our team, Alexa Dapp.
Thanks, Ed. Yeah, Fordham announcing their decision to shut down center Ryan Canty for the remainder of the season due to that off-season back surgery. He will redshirt with the intent of playing next year. When I spoke to Canty a little while ago, he was more or less upbeat, saying he's just excited to be fully healthy for the first time in his college basketball career, Ed.
All right, Alexa. So Ryan Canty, they lose his presence for the year on the boards. UMass Lowell, there's their head coach, Pat Duquette, second year leading the Riverhawks, former assistant to Al Skinner at Boston College. Let's meet tonight's starting lineups presented by Zipcar. Get $35 in free drive time when you sign up at zipcar.com/Fordham. Jahad Thomas has been the star for UMass Lowell, averaging 14.5 points per game in their first four. And for Fordham, Brian Smith will get the nod despite some ankle issues. The starting five for both squads. Tom Pecora in his fifth year leading the Fordham Rams. Former head coach at Hofstra. Tom Pecora, longtime assistant to Jay Wright for 7 years before becoming a Division I head coach. Oh, Vin, Fordham coming off those two losses on the road, but a noticeable size advantage here against guard-heavy UMass Lowell. They're going to try and exploit that size here tonight.
Absolutely, and not just with rooms in the middle, with the guards on the perimeter as well.
Tonight's opening tip-off brought to you by Liberty Mutual. Quality and affordable auto insurance, home insurance, and life insurance. Our first look at Eric Paschal. Stripped and now taken by Shad Holly of UMass Lowell. And a steal. Nicely played by Nemanja Zarkovic, the freshman from Montreal, Quebec, on the pull-up. Too much from Mandel Thomas. He's got it now, Zarkovic. And Fordham is going to get a reset here. We're scoreless after 40 seconds.
Sometimes you can take the size for granted. Rooms right there could have went up and powered that offensive rebound in for two. Take it when you could get it.
Zarkovic. Would have been a three. Long rebound out to Jahad Thomas. Fordham struggled from three. 7 of 29 at Maryland. 8 of 27 at Penn State.
This guy with the basketball, Thomas, we have to keep an eye on. He's led UMass Lowell in scoring three times already this season.
Ryan Rooms with the help in the block, and Fordham is going to get it back. Let's look at tonight's series history presented by the Mall at Bay Plaza, located at 200 Baychester Avenue. It's the most spectacular fashion destination in the Bronx. And this is meeting number one. Of course, Fordham with a long basketball history in Division I. UMass Lowell in the midst of their transition. And this is going to stay with the Riverhawks. Last touch by Fordham.
Saw head coach Pat Duquette trying to help the officials there with that one, and he was successful.
Tough challenge for Pat Duquette, but he's taken the reins. Last year, they were picked last in the America East preseason poll, as it's put in for the first points from Kerry Weldon. But they ended up finishing a lot better than that, 8-8 in conference. Picked ninth, they finished fifth. Paschal on the catch and shoot. That's a three for the freshman from Dobbs Ferry in Westchester.
This is why he was such a highly touted recruit when Tom Pecora signed him. Not a lot of guys that size that can stretch you on the perimeter.
Thomas frees up Benegas Flores. Long bounce. And now Zarkovic back the other way for the Rams. Paschal frees up Thomas. Almost the second straight three for the Rams.
That was the right shot off penetration. Make those open ones.
Thomas. Another long bounce. Thomas for Zarkovic. Paschal trailing the play. Would have been his second three. And it's tracked down by Chad Holly.
Zarkovic has terrific court vision. You see, he knows when to pull it out. He knows when to get the early skip pass.
Fordham's open this game 1 of 5. UMass Lowell 1 of 4.
Aggressive half-court man-to-man defense here early for the Rams.
Thomas against Sengfelder. Called for steps. Well defended by the native of Germany, 6'8", Chris Sengfelder. As Brian Smith gets set to check in for Fordham. This was earlier from Paschal.
We mentioned it at the top. 31 points, broke the school freshman record for his debut. And wasn't too long ago that that record was broken by one of his teammates last season, Ed.
That being John Sevier, who was the former New York State Player of the Year. To have back-to-back program guys for Tom Pecora, first Sevier and now Paschal. Now it's just a matter of getting it all to blend together. We'll see what Eric Paschal can do in just a few games.
Well, let's talk about what Tom Pecora needs to do today. You got to use that size, and it's not just down low with your post players. When the guards have the advantage, go at them as well. And as we mentioned at the top, Jahad Thomas, he's the guy that could go off offensively for head coach Pat Duquette.
And tonight's keys to the game presented by Modell's, the one store for all your sporting goods needs. Ed Cohen, Vin Parisi, Alexa Datt, our entire crew from Rose Hill Gym in the Bronx. Fordham Rams come in 1-2. UMass Lowell 2-2 after wins against Sacred Heart and NJIT. Nemanja Zarkovic off the curl, knocks it down from three.
He got it done early, and he got it done with his footwork. That's when you see releases the quickest from behind the arc. Great job, fundamentally.
Six to two, Rams in front. Threes from Haskell and Zarkovic. Gary Weldon looking for his second bucket. Zarkovic looking down low. Haskell with the flush.
Haskell with authority, but there's that court vision by Zarkovic that we just talked about.
Against a team playing its third game in 4 days, the Rams clearly looking to push the pace, and here they come again with Zarkovic. Gave it up. Marco Benegas Flores coasts in for two after the steal.
He's playing hard. Tom Pecora giving him a look right there, saying, now start playing a little smarter.
No doubt a learning curve. Fordham team that returns four starters. They won 10 games a year ago. Knocked out of bounds. It'll stay with Fordham when we come back. The 6'6 freshman. He's built like a tight end, but he's playing basketball on this Sunday. Eric Paschal knocking down the three. And later, from Zarkovic, Fordham up early. Fordham with the early 4-point lead. Eric Haskell has scored 5 early points. And for more, we go to Alexa Dan.
Eric Haskell having a little bit of a medical scare early on in the season. In that Penn State game, coaches noticed that he was laboring to catch his breath. So they pulled him and sent him to a pulmonologist where they tested his lung capacity. They also sent him to a cardiologist where they tested his heart and actually found an irregular heartbeat. He did not travel to Maryland, didn't play in that game. But then once his heart was monitored, they found out that his heartbeat was fine and he was cleared to play. Doesn't seem like he's having any issues with his heart here tonight, guys.
Been always scary. You want to take the most precaution. That's why they held him back. And it's great after a couple of days to see him back out there.
Yeah, better to be on the safe side. And we had a chance to chat with head coach Tom Pecora in his office about 2 hours before the game. You know, slight heart murmurs are not uncommon in big, strong athletes, but better to be safe.
UMass Lowell with the ball. They trail 8-4 with just over 5 minutes gone by here at Rose Hill Gym. Venegas Flores here against Arkovic. Fordham trying to switch on him with 8 to shoot.
Good show. Pick and roll defense huge for the Rams today.
Block three from Ryan Rooms. Shot clock at 2 as he denies Tyler Livingston.
Now you got to be solid, do not foul, and be ready to switch screens. Only 2 seconds of defense.
Well defended, blocked underneath Thomas with the attempt, and the Rams will get it back. That size for Tom Pokora's squad in this game, very noticeable against the smaller UMass Lowell squad.
An effective job of communicating early by the Rams out of their half-court defense. You can tell they worked on pick-and-roll defense at the shoot-around.
Mandel Thomas will be at the line. Backing down 5'10", Lance Crawford. And that is the first foul of this game against the UMass Lowell freshman.
They don't just have to look inside for guys like Pascal and Rooms. That time, Mandel Thomas with the smaller guard on his back.
Mandel Thomas made his first start of the year in Maryland. He had the green light. He scored 14 points, but it came on 5 of 20 shooting. But a guy who had a great freshman year, and they feel he could be somewhat of a secret weapon this season.
And he could get streaky in a good way as well. And so several times last season, the Rams would ride his hot hand.
Lead back up to 6 for Fordham. Thomas sets a screen. Holly now trying to get around Zarkovic. Long three, and Rooms had the rebound, but Smith able to provide some help. And finally, Zarkovic corrals it. Zengfelder looking back door. Extra pass. Another extra feed. And it's a foul. Jahad Thomas holding up Ryan Rooms.
Well, you don't often hear it, but they might have been a little too unselfish that time. Great ball reversal, 4 white jerseys touching the rock in a matter of seconds, but threw down to a double team in the short corner.
Eric Pascal back in the game, along with John Sevier. So last year's second leading scorer for Fordham comes in at 13-44 in the first half. Too much from Rooms. Last touched by Pascal.
I like that action on that baseline out of bounds there, though, by Tom Pokora. The little throwback to the inbounder. Sneak right back in along the baseline behind the defense.
Ten to four, Fordham in front. Holly. Now Crawford. Livingston sets a big screen. Tyler Livingston, sharpshooter, number 24 in blue. Crawford well defended by Zarkovic. Shot clock at 5. Long three from Harris. Good defense there at the half court by the Rams.
What a terrific job by Zarkovic, moving his feet without fouling.
Zengfelder, the native of Germany, lights it up from 3.
He's had the size advantage on multiple possessions here, but showing that he has those skills to stretch the perimeter defense.
Third three for Fordham. UMass Lowell 0-4 from 3. Chad Holly, number 4 in blue, formerly of Mount St. Mary's, gets it back from Harris. It's a 3. Rebound for Livingston. Right back out for Crawford. Blocked by Rooms. Ryan Rooms, a big presence so far at 6'8 for the Rams. And back the other way, it's a blocking foul. And it's on Matt Harris of UMass Lowell.
Okay, whatever Tom Pokora fed these guys for the pregame meal, and he should keep it going for future games. This guy's got a pep in their step defensively here early.
There's an old story at St. John's. Walter Berry once went down the street and ordered lobster ravioli before a game. The coaches were scared to see how he'd play. I think he scored 28 that game, and they said, "You eat what you like."
A lot of lobster for the rest of the season.
That's a heavy meal right there. Matt Harris fouled on the way up by Sengfelder. And the freshman from Erie, Pennsylvania will be at the line for UMass Lowell.
Down early, 13-4. The River Hawks need to, you have to do this sometimes. You cannot just walk it up, play against a set defense, try to run sets for the entire 40 minutes. Every once in a while, you need to push the pace, pitch it ahead, and try to get an easy run out.
Manny Suarez in for the first time for Fordham, replacing Sengfelder. One thing both of these bigs have in common is they can shoot it. And Tom Pecora is someone who's always liked to stretch the floor.
Absolutely. Sengfelder, 50% from downtown thus far on the year.
One of two trip from Matt Harris. 8 minutes gone by, 13-5. Fordham leading UMass Lowell. Sevier skips it out. Zarkovic for Paschal, trying to throw it down with authority, and it popped out. Paschal's got it back. Offensive foul.
Got a jump stop there, big fella.
Not getting the dunk spin, but Nair is certainly hitting from three.
Stretching the day, the big fellas for Tom Pecora. Shoot it just as well.
Rams lead at 13-5, and they are getting it done from three-point range.
Well, you look at the roster for Tom Pecora, particularly along the baseline. Zengfelder's 50% on the year from downtown. The game where Eric Paschal went for 31 points, he had four trays. You know, you can talk about wanting to run, wanting to get out in transition. You can talk about defense, but eventually, you need to make the long ball. You have to shoot it well in the world of college hoops these days. And whenever you can stifle the other team's three-point shooting and shoot it well yourself, good things are going to happen.
Nemanja Zarkovic has hit one of them. Point guard from Sherbrooke, Quebec. And he is one of those classic Eastern European point guards. Tom Pecora had a number of players from that region of the world when he was at Hofstra. They dividend so far. 13-5 lead on UMass Lowell. Crawford squeezing by John Sevier, and he gets the bounce.
Wasn't that dribble penetration that hurt him as much as the lack of help side defense right there. Coaching staff wanted more white jerseys in the paint.
Suarez lost the handle. Taken back by Crawford.
So you got to dig in. You have to get into your defensive stance early versus Lowell. You'll see multiple dribble handoffs and pick and rolls each trip.
Matt Harris had an open three. In and out. UMass Lowell has struggled to score, averaging less than 58 points in their first four games. Runes against Kerry Weldon. Tough shot. Good help there from Tyler Livingston.
Terrific help side defense as a team. Three blue jerseys converged.
Holly, the crossover, and it's a blocking foul inside. Ryan Rooms, who's already blocked three shots, but right there is called for the blocking foul.
Rooms was in between his man and the basket. That's what he's telling the official, but you need to be set. See the slide? See him riding the hip there? He needed to be there about half a second earlier. Make that penetrator run you over.
Rooms out to Kiba Bateaston.
Oh,
from Australia's
easy.
In. Going right at him, and a missed shot there from UMass Lowell. One for their last nine now. Reach and foul on Weldon. Trying to slow down John Sevier. John Sevier has yet to take a shot here today. He is 1 for 8 on the season. He's 1 of 3 at Maryland, 0 of 5 at Penn State. Dyer averaged 17 points per game last year. As Fordham turns it over, what does he need to do? Obviously, the opportunities haven't been there to at least get that part of his game back.
Well, you know, your sophomore year, Ed, it's a whole nother learning curve. You know, the reason why the saying sophomore jinx exists, it's not so much a jinx, it's the fact that people have a year of film on you already. You're not a freshman anymore. And you need to adjust your game. You need to add those second and third options because everybody knows what your primary option is going to be. But the defense right now is what Tom Pokora is not happy with, folks. See defenders flying in the air, guys falling for shot fakes, and guys not stepping up on the weak side.
Kerry Weldon at the line for a chance at three. It was fouled by Dekeba Bateaston. Going to stay with UMass Lowell. Proud sponsor of Fordham Athletics, Harley Construction Management provides services to major organizations in and around the New York metro area. For more information, please visit harleyconstruction.com. 13-9 Rams over the River Hawks with 9:43 to go first half. Vegas Flores, and now Crawford trying to get around the 6'8 Sengfelder. Inside Livingston, and a ball that was tipped goes reverse and puts it in.
We've gone from 13-4 to 13-11. They need a good possession right now on this offensive trip.
Pascal off the bounce. UMass Lowell now the chance to extend a 7-0 run. They're within two.
That's what Pascal will learn. When the team's on a run, your opponent gets some ball reversals, get a good, solid, high percentage look. Not saying you cannot take contested jumpers, but you have to know when.
Zarkovic with the help, forcing the tough shot. Fordham scoreless for more than 3 minutes. Pascal. And it's stolen away by Harris. He's got Crawford behind him. Harris all the way to the basket, but he extended the arm. Offensive foul.
Pat Duquette is going crazy on the UMass Lowell sideline. I actually thought he was going to drop it back at a little behind the back. He had his trailer there calling for it. Instead, he chose to take it himself.
Second foul on Matt Harris. Fordham already with 8 turnovers in 11 minutes, and that's opened the door for UMass Lowell to make this 7-0 run.
And you have to take care of the basketball. This is something that's plagued them a little bit. And 16 turnovers in the last outing versus Maryland, 17 turnovers when they played Penn State, something Tom Pokora has been talking to the guys about during their film sessions.
Pascal on a switch. Zaire Thompson, number 5 in white, now in for Fordham. Scoreless for Fordham trails UMass Lowell by 1 at the break. Our first half stats are brought to you by the Fordham Maroon Club, proud sponsor of Fordham basketball. Fordham 3 of 12 from 3, but then they were 3 of 6 to start, and they missed their last 6 from 3-point range.
And you can't turn it over as much. That's the killer stat, because they'd have more attempts, or maybe they get into a flow, get into a shooting rhythm. It's all choppy. There's no rhythm or flow when you have 12 turnovers in 20 minutes.
We'll see if they feel Topacor's love when we come back. Second half is coming up. This is UMass Lowell's second year playing a Division I schedule, but at the break, they lead Fordham 25-24. Alexa Dant spoke with head coach Pat Duquette moments ago. Alexa.
Yeah, Ed, Coach Pat Duquette was impressed with their offensive execution, saying that just keep shooting those shots and eventually they'll fall in the second half. But he said defensively, we showed courage, we fought. That's definitely something that they were looking for pregame. He said they executed it very well in the first half.
No question, this is a team that lost on the road to Ohio State and Rhode Island to begin the season. A couple of wins against Sacred Heart and NJIT. And here they are up by one on Fordham, but after a turnover, back come the Rams.
Rhode Island with a terrific win for the Atlantic 10 last night against number 21, Nebraska.
Danny Hurley really getting things going there in Kingston. Tied up in the arrow, says it's going to stay with the Rams. But you look at Pat Duquette, they opened the year with 5 games on the road in 10 days. They're playing their third game in 4 days here today. That is the scheduling equivalent of diving right in.
Yes, yes it is. You know what's, yeah, I'm surprised more ball clubs don't do that. Think about it. I know it sounds crazy. Why would you want to play back-to-back games on a road? Think of March, or think of the early season tournaments in November and December, but think of your conference tournament.
Yeah.
You're playing a game, and on less than 24 hours notice, you have to get ready, scout. Be interesting to see if, you know, why more teams, you know, not saying literally back-to-backs, but maybe 2 game swings over weekends, 2 games in 3 days. But Pat Duquette, good bloodlines in his coaching family. You look at Pat Duquette, you look at Bill Cohen from Northeastern,
yep.
You look at Ed Cooley from Providence, all 3 of those guys on the same Boston College staff about 10 years ago for Al Skinner. Look at the success of that entire group.
Played a lot of different Rays from the flex, pushing the tempo, and right now with the team playing strong half-court defense, is tied up with Fordham with over a minute gone by in the second half. That ball stripped from Venegas Flores. It's going to stay with UMass Lowell. And Pat Duquette's older brother is no stranger to New York fans. Jim Duquette, the former Mets GM, also with the Orioles, and now an analyst on SNY. Jim, one of the real good guys covering baseball. That's a 3 for Chad Holley.
I'll tell you, not something we have seen a lot of. 5 three-pointers made, folks, combined in the first half by both ball clubs.
Thomas on a catch and shoot. Look at Rooms for a weak side rebound. Zarkovic. This time they knocked down a 3 and we're tied up again.
And offensive rebounds, free throws, all these little intangible stats, kickouts. That's going to be crucial on a night where both teams are having some cold shooting streaks.
Second tie of the game, we're knotted up at 28. 4-3 for Fordham in 13 attempts. Weldon, too much. Rooms sets it up for Zarkovic. Pascal. Back-to-back threes for Fordham. And they come from freshman Zarkovic and now Pascal.
Pascal set the feet, but Zarkovic set the table.
Yep.
Got the basketball to the middle of the floor. I just love his court vision and the pace of play, how he operates.
Venegas Flores, too much. Weldon scoops it up, re-enters the lane, and will be at the line for a chance at 3. Sengfelder got him on the way
up.
Oh,
my.
Gary Weldon jumping through the roof.
Kerry Weldon, who went 2 for 4 with just 1 rebound in the first 20 minutes, putting his athleticism and vertical leap, folks, on display here. Early second half, got his entire bench and fan section there up and going, and these guys feel like they are right in this one. Oh my, it's a little hard.
3 of 12 from the line now this year for Weldon. And you could see it right off the bat. So Fordham maintains its 1-point lead. We're nearly 3 minutes in, second half. Boy, Rooms clears out a lot of space.
He does. How about those mismatches of when Moon sets the ball screen when Pascal's handling the rock?
Zarkovic with five to shoot. In for Rooms, but a charge. Offensive foul. And it's drawn by Kerry Weldon.
We have not seen this often tonight. Zarkovic out of control. That's about the first time he's left the floor not under control.
Venegas Flores could have been offensive goaltending. That was in the cylinder as Weldon came in, but they let it go.
Yeah, they did not need to do that. That was dropping anyway, but I thought they would wave that off, and that's not allowed when it's in the cylinder.
Rooms, little touch from behind. He'll be at the line for a chance at three.
Tom Pecor is hot right now at the officials for those 2 points at the other end. They got it right back. Strong baseline drive by Thomas. The help side defender has to come over, and Rooms dive into the front of the cup as the big men are supposed to.
Three-point play for Ryan Rooms. And Fordham's lead now at 2, 34-32, with over 3.5 gone by since the break. Fordham has a size advantage, but points in the paint, a much different approach from UMass Lowell tonight.
Your interior defense has to be strong, and it's not just about throwing it into the post and post speeds. It's about that, dribble penetration. Think about how many times the perimeter guys have gotten into the lane or gotten 2 feet in the paint.
Second foul on Nemanja Zarkovic. Off the inbounds, Venegas Flores drills the three. He has scored 9, and UMass Lowell reclaims the lead.
Complete defensive breakdown. Not a defender within 5 or 6 feet of him.
That's Rooms, and using his size to hit over Weldon.
The Rams have to communicate and put together a good defensive stop here.
Venegas Flores, the switch and the finish.
They are playing with a high level of confidence on the offensive end right now.
The cutter's Pascal lost the handle. He was stripped. It's going to stay with Fordham. 10 lead changes so far, and UMass Lowell here on the road making a game of it and some, leading Fordham by 1. Venegas Flores, Jordan-like to the left. Time now to take a look at the latest top 10 from the Associated Press, brought to you by Coach USA, proud sponsor of Fordham Athletics. Kentucky still number one after what they did to Kansas earlier this week.
Yeah, but I tell you who I love, who's not going to leave the top of that list. This could be Coach K's best team in a long time.
No doubt.
Their size, they have shooting, they have Okafor, the best big guy maybe in the country. Young talent with his back to the basket. The polish on his moves, but how about Calipari in Kentucky? 9 McDonald's All-Americans.
It's like a hockey team. They have
shifts.
Thomas, second effort. Mandel Thomas has given Fordham the lead once again. 7 lead changes now in this half alone.
Yeah, they're in a dogfight. There's no doubt about it. Tom Pokora needs multiple guys to step up and come through right now.
5 minutes gone by since the break. 38-37, Fordham.
Little zone in the half court for the Rams.
Thomas had the step on Zarkovic, and the finish against Rooms.
Listen, somebody, if not two guys, are going to hear it from the coaching staff in the film sessions when they review this one, because it does not matter if you're in a half-court man-to-man or if you're in a zone. There cannot be a straight line drive, an immediate blow-by on the perimeter, and then the help side be late.
Jahan Thomas averaged over 14 per game coming in for UMass Lowell. Problem is, they're 1 of 5 as a team from the foul line. Thomas takes it himself and scoops it in for two.
Talk about high degree of difficulty make.
Holly gets it back and hits from three. Chad Holly now at 9.
And his third three-pointer. They need to get him off the arc. He's too comfortable here tonight with his feet are set. They need to make him a penetrator, force him into tough twos.
Would have been a foul, but before that, steps on Zarkovic. 14 turnovers now for Fordham.
So he is feeling it. They need to identify him, whether it's the zone, the low corner man coming out. Close out, high hands. Make him take contested pull-up jumpers.
This time it's Crawford. That's tipped on the way up. Thomas got his hand on it. And the Rams can tie with the two or take the lead with the three. Singfelder wants the lead. In midair, put back up. Thomas too much. Rooms in a battle. Tied up by Livingston, and Ryan Rooms will be at the line.
See, a year or two ago, Rooms would have brought that down. That's when you see young big guys get stripped. So he immediately chinned that. Those elbows are out. That basketball did not come down near the waist. When you chin it, 99% of the time, the referees will protect your face. You will get the whistle. You bring it low, they give the defensive advantage to the guards. Slapping in on it.
Eric Paschal back in for Fordham will replace Brian Smith and John Sevier, who played just 6 minutes in the first half, replaces Singfelder. Matt Harris back in for UMass Lowell for Benegas Flores. We're tied up at 42 with 13:38 to play. Thomas against Sevier. LePoke. Holly. Extension of the arm, and it's on Zarkovic. And that's one of the elements that the referees are emphasizing this year. You cannot push your arm out against the ball handler. Different in the post with your back to the basket, but right there, Thomas had the lane.
Yeah, and it was tight, and Holly didn't need to because he was moving his feet so well.
Holly starting to get hot right now.
Leading them on the offensive end. They've maintained this slight lead.
Zarkovic keeps control. Paschal. Sevier, weak side board. And the Rams looking to pull it out. Instead, Thomas on the drive will be at the line for two. Fouled by Jahad Thomas from UMass Lowell.
The good news for the Rams is Tom Pokora's guards are crashing the offensive boards and being aggressive off the drive. I think the guards are getting in there just as much as the bigs, the offensive backboards. Before Thomas, it was John Sevier. Weak side, crashing. When you're in dogfights, when you're in these tough ones at home, where maybe the shots aren't dropping, maybe the offensive execution numbers aren't where you want them to be, you need to pick up 8 to 10 hustle points. That's how you grind out these tough ones, non-conference-wise.
Manuel Thomas with those free throws has now scored 10, and we're tied up again. Fordham out rebounding UMass Lowell 32-19 with their guards. Lance Crawford gets the screen. Chad Holly, number 4 in blue, has already scored 8 this half. Crosses over Thompson. Now it's Harris against Sevier. Shot clock at 7. Sevier with the stellar defense and the steal.
That was one of their best half-court defensive possessions of the ball game.
Rooms in a battle of blue jerseys. Sets up Sevier. Rooms again, another offensive board. And a late whistle, but a foul called. The 5th foul on UMass Lowell this half. Fordham also with 5.
Well, Tom Pokora said John Sevier needs to start making shots. He's taking good ones right now. They're hustling on the offensive backboards.
This is Fordham, right? Yeah, I know. No, Fordham, yeah. Yep, you're good, thank you.
John Sevier's taken only one shot. Remember, he averaged 17 points a game last year for Fordham. But if he's doing this, the coaching staff will certainly take it. Let's get more from Alexa Dapp.
Ed, before tonight, John Sevier had only played in 22 minutes, scoring only 2 points on the season. That was mainly due to the weak suspension he was given for violating team rules by Tom Pokora. Pokora told me that when he came back from that suspension, though, he's seen a lot more fight in him from practice. He said, really, the thing with Sevier is that he's just got to grow up. He also noted that this is the first time in his career where he's had to compete for minutes.
All right, Alexa, this is a guy who came in under great expectations, certainly delivered last year. Number 10 in white is out there on the floor right now with this game tied at 44 and under 12 to go. Rosso, Jim in the Bronx, Ed Cohen, Vin Parisi, Alexa Datt, and our crew led by Joel Cote, Atlantic 10 Network on SNY. Here is Sevier, second shot attempt, in and out. Tyler Livingston, big board there for UMass Lowell.
This is where all the little things can come back to bite you. You need to be solid, close out on the perimeter without fouling. Most importantly, take care of the defensive boards at the end of the possession.
Crawford draws a second man, so it's Livingston. And in midair, Weldon. Livingston again. Pascal got a piece. Where's the size for Fordham as Weldon brings it out? Listen to the crowd getting on the Rams as Crawford is fouled on the way up. Now, was he near the line? Was it a two or a three? Three shots for Lance
three
Crawford.
Three shots. The cardinal sin of defense. Allow three free throws by the opposition. You cannot foul the three-point shot under any circumstance. You need to chop your feet, sit down low, jump straight up and down on your contest, not forward into the shooter.
UMass Lowell is now 1 of 6 at the line.
But that's not what got them in trouble, Ed. What got them in trouble was the loose balls.
Yep.
Was not securing the defensive backboards, as we had just mentioned. Need to give it to these Riverhawks. They are scrappy.
Pat Duquette's team playing for the third time in 4 days. And it's a 1 of 3 trip for Lance Crawford as UMass Lowell's back up by one. He said, can only show the kids so much tape of three different opponents, Sacred Heart and NJIT being the other two. They didn't watch much tape on Fordham, but they're playing their guts out right now. And a jump ball call. Thomas tied it up with Holly, and the arrow says it'll stay with UMass Lowell.
Pat Duquette really heated on the sidelines. Look, that was a quick whistle for the jump. He realized he had possession, though.
Running through the high post with Livingston. Crawford. And a touch foul. John Sevier picks up his first.
You want to be aggressive, and you want to apply that ball pressure. You want to try to turn defense into offense and force turnovers, but you need to be smart as well.
That was a 17 foul on Fordham, so Crawford at the line for a bonus trip, and he earns himself one more. Lance Crawford from Davie, Florida. The Tompkins program has been around for a while. UMass Lowell, in the second year of a four-year transition as a Division I program, they don't get their pick with a lot of recruits. So to bring in a guy from Florida and Lance Crawford, certainly a good sign as they try to expand their reach. And a turnover from Thomas. Crawford getting a screen from Weldon. And look at Pascal guarding a guy who's 5'10".
And he's going to have to do that often this season.
On a switch, Crawford against Zarkovic. And Zarkovic back for the rebound.
They're doing an effective job switching a lot of stuff in the half court. You just need to communicate every single time. One time not calling it out can burn you from deep.
Tyler Livingston picks up the foul. That's the sixth on UMass Lowell. Applebee's is a proud sponsor of Fordham Athletics. Be sure to stop by the Fordham Plaza location for the Monday Night Quarterback radio show. Pascal on the drive. Oh, offensive foul. And they've drawn a couple of those. Kerry Weldon sets his feet to draw the foul again.
Well, that's the second time tonight, Ed, that the freshman has put it on the deck and left his feet and not jump stopped. You leave your feet, the defender's willing to step in and take the hit, it's going to be an offensive charge. It's going to be a turnover.
Here's UMass Lowell against Atlantic 10 opponents. Remember, they played a Division I schedule for the first time last year. And they lost to Rhode Island earlier this season. Gary Weldon wraps around and scores, giving them 8 points.
Yeah, they're in the second of that four-year transition from Division II to Division I. We've seen Bryan, University out of the NEC, do it recently and have some success. But it's a long-term process, to say the least.
Yeah, but this is a program that won the Division II national title in 1988. The current freshmen now will be seniors when they can first play in a conference tournament, in the America East, or in the NCAA tournament. But you go back to Greg Kurenda, who is now at FDU, Fairleigh Dickinson, a great run in Division II. And look at what they're doing now in D1.
Absolutely. FDU knocking off St. Joe's out of the Atlantic 10 last week.
Sevier to his jump stop, and he floats it in, and John Sevier is on the board tonight.
Must feel like about 300 pounds has been lifted off his shoulders with that make.
Thomas against Sengfelder, used his speed to turn him around.
Sengfelder wanted the little hook with the offhand. Might have been out of view from the three officials.
Room is posting up on Weldon. Skip out for Sengfelder. Thomas with some room.
Oh, it's got to be something.
Studio player of the game is Shad Holly. Really took over in the second half. From the outside bin, really set the tone for the Riverhawks.
He was heady. He was smart with the basketball. Didn't turn it over, but more importantly, like we just saw with those clips, he hit daggers. Whenever Fordham was trying to apply that defensive pressure, trying to get an offensive run going, he would hit a dagger. But you also saw he did other things to Pat Duquette. The 5 rebounds, the 4 assists. Terrific floor game at both ends.
Pizza Studio located on East Fordham Road with discounts for Fordham students. Stop by and make your own pie. Only thing UMass Lowell has not done is make their free throws down the stretch. 9 of 10 they've missed. Upcoming schedule brought to you by Courtyard Marriott LaGuardia. Here on SNY, it'll be Maryland Eastern Shore Saturday the 29th. And then when we hit December, Jimmy Patsos brings Siena to town, another MAC opponent in Monmouth. And we close the month before the new year with Howard and South Carolina State.
Jimmy Patsos will bring that intensity here to Rose Hill. It's going to be a tough Thanksgiving week here for the Rams, but you heard Tom Pecora tell Alexa, going off at the half, we look like we're young at times when we play, and they're going to go through these growing pains.
That's 11 of 12 missed down the stretch from UMass Lowell. Final seconds. Severe out for Sengfelder, but it's all for naught at this point. UMass Lowell, 3 wins in 4 days, including back-to-back at NJIT and now at Fordham. A terrific win for Pat Duquette's program and a tough one to swallow for the Fordham Rams here on their home floor.
Give UMass Lowell credit. These kids came in. Fordham had the size advantage at multiple positions. And they were scrappy, tough, hustled on the defensive end, played together and played with confidence, most importantly, on the offensive end.
Real quick, Fordham goes back to the drawing board. What's Tom Pecora going to tell his group?
I think it starts with the defense. You know, as much as we love to dissect the offense and look at shooting numbers, Tom Pecora is a stickler for half-court defensive field goal percentage. And UMass Lowell shot around 50% the entire second half. The film does not lie.
UMass Lowell now 3-2 on the season. Fordham falls to 1-3 before they welcome Maryland Eastern Shore on Saturday the 29th. Final score in this one, UMass Lowell takes it 64-57. Coverage of Fordham basketball on SNY continues on Saturday when the Rams host the University of Maryland Eastern Shore. Coverage begins at 4 p.m. right here on SNY. This has been a presentation of the Atlantic 10 Conference. Once again, our final score from the Bronx, 64-57, UMass Lowell. Coming up next on SNY, it's the UConn women's basketball team against Creighton.
Thursday, yeah. And NJIT was yesterday. Okay. We did our best there to spin it for them, but you have to give credit where credit's due. I mean, they played their balls off. That's one too. We had a lot of other material. We could have gone a lot of places, but we had to, the whole game we had to stay the second half.
It's one of those games where you think that if it's a 20-point game, you need to go elsewhere.
Right.
We didn't have to do anything.
No.
That was wow.
Pat, good job. Congrats.
Okay, so on camera, lights on. Great. So two on campus. Okay. Great. Great. Okay. We have time for an opening comment. Okay. Great.
Cool.
Okay. Final score at Rose Hill Gym. UMass Lowell takes it at Fordham, 64-57. And welcome back, Ed Cohen, with the former college coach Vin Parisi. Disappointing effort from Fordham. Terrific win for UMass Lowell. Second year playing a Division I schedule, and the squad from the America East wins its third game in 4 days.
Impressive. You think they win at Sacred Heart on Thursday. They beat NJIT yesterday. And to come out here on the road versus an Atlantic 10 opponent, Pat Duquette's guys showed a lot of poise.
Good news for Fordham, it was a strong effort from Eric Haskell, showing glimpses of why they're so excited about this freshman. He led the way with 16 points, getting it done in all sorts of ways.
Yeah, he played with a lot of confidence early, particularly in the first half. He was comfortable when he put the ball on the deck, and he was effective when his feet were set from deep. The problem was that the big fella just could not get those open looks. They keyed in on him in the second half particularly well.
And looking at the numbers, a big one that jumps out for Fordham, the 18 turnovers compared to just 8 for UMass Lowell. That was a struggle. UMass Lowell wins this game despite going 7-for-26 from the foul line. That's something they'll work on, but the fact is Fordham needs to work on their ball control and also their defense, Vin.
Yeah, and remember now, turnovers were an issue versus Penn State, versus Maryland, almost 20 turnovers again here today. That's a big reason why they only shot 33%. You cannot get into an offensive rhythm when you're turning it over that much. Now, that being said, UMass Lowell shot nearly 50% the entire second half there. Tom Pokor will go back to the drawing board, but it's going to start with the defense.
As we look at Fordham's upcoming schedule, they welcome Maryland Eastern Shore to town on Saturday the 29th before a couple of MAC opponents, Siena and Monmouth, come to Rose Hill Gym. We will have those games and more in the month of December on SNY. UMass Lowell comes on the road and wins it at Rose Hill Gym, 64-57 on the Atlantic 10 Network on SNY.